Hey guys, before we start this video, I want to shout out my brand new Discord server one last time. If you want to talk to me and maybe play some games together, this is the best way to do so. Anyway guys, thank you all for clicking on the video and I hope you enjoy. So, yesterday, the devs of Fishing Simulator posted a really big Q&A in their announcement section and showcased some teasers about what they want to do with the game. This time it was quite a lot, so I figured let's go over it together, give me my thoughts, and see what the future of Fishing Simulator holds for us. The first thing I want to talk about is that the new update is coming on Sunday. Now, before you get your hopes up, the Fishing Simulator devs do have a history of delaying the update by a day or two. So if it's not here on Sunday, it will be here on Monday. So the first two things that we are getting on Sunday are two of the most requested features I have ever seen in this game. The first feature we are gonna get is daily login rewards. That's just amazing. Everybody wanted it. I really hope they are gonna put gems in the daily rewards, but they haven't given info about that yet, so we just have to wait and see. The second thing that they're gonna add is more gem quests, and I am so happy about this. As somebody that does Rayman's quests for gems a lot, they get really boring after a while, because it keeps being the same quest over and over and over again. And having some more quest variety will certainly spice things up. But there is one more thing that will be added on Sunday, and that is neon sharks. They posted a little video on their Discord showing off the neon sharks. We have no idea how they work yet, but we can assume that these are rare shark spawns. It would be really cool if these neon sharks could drop a shark egg in a neon variant. Couldn't you imagine having your entire shark tank with neon sharks? That would be absolutely amazing. And makes farming creatures worth it again. Because right now, there isn't really an incentive to farm creatures that much. But they didn't only give us update information. In fact, they give us an entire Q&A talking about future updates and what they want to do with the game. And this is what I mostly want to go over with you guys, because it is really interesting. So first off, we asked, when is the aquarium update? So the aquarium update is this big update they are planning to revamp the entire aquarium. You will be able to build your own tanks and put fish in it, really cool. Their response was, it's still being worked on. We expect to be done with it near the end of May. So that's pretty good news. That means that we probably only have to wait around 20 more days. So that's really cool. The next question we ask, do I need to take fish out of my aquarium? So that would be really annoying to get your fish out, get your sharks out. But luckily they thought of it, because their response was, no, you have a storage where you will be able to find them, but your decorations and theirs will be fully refunded. So when the aquarium update drops, expect a lot of gold all of a sudden, so you can buy maybe the jet ski or something else. So we also ask, when are new islands and fish coming? So their response was pretty expected. This month they will be focusing on the aquarium update, pets and rebalancing, and that the islands and fish will come at a later date. So there won't be an island or fish this month, but there will be another month. So here is where it gets really interesting. When are pets coming? Either the end of the month or early June. I understand it's been sneak peeked a long time ago, but it's now getting attention and planning it needs to be done. So pets are something that I'm really hyped about and also really scared about, because they can either break the game and ruin the fun or make this game amazing. And seeing how the devs will come up with balancing the pets will be really interesting. And this next thing, oh my god. Will pets be blocky? No, We intended to design our pets realistically, such as parrots, an alligator, monkeys, etc. So we will not get those lazily designed pets, we will get fully thought out amazing pets. So if you're wondering what they will look like, a couple of months ago, they actually showed a sneak peek of what the parrot pet will look like, and it looks pretty cool. What will pets do? We are still working on something concrete, but they won't do anything to ruin the game experience, which is really reassuring for me. It should hopefully help you with your fishing index completion. Thank God, the fishing index looks so impossible to complete right now. And if pets maybe have stats like, oh, you have more chance to get fish you haven't caught yet, or you have more neon chance, that would be absolutely amazing. Another question they asked was, why is every recent update so expensive and for veterans? So, if you're really thinking about it, we got the Lambos, we got the super expensive Spearses update, the jet ski also isn't that cheap, but it's not too bad. Newbie players really can't do anything with the update. Their response was, we lack endgame content for our players in the upper levels, and everybody needs new content to stay invested in the game, which I totally agree with. If they only add stuff for the low level players, I would get bored and probably quit. Once you get to the higher levels, you would prefer that there will be more goals to work towards. We have more content soon for everybody. So with the more content soon for everybody, I'm guessing they mean pets. And with more content for veterans, I guess they mean neon shark hunting and the new island. And last but not least, the question that everybody asked about, the suggestion that everybody asked about, will you add trading? No, because we don't want to invite duplication glitches, but more than that, we want players to visit each island and collect the fish. It wouldn't be fair if a level 20 traded for something higher level players worked hard for. And this is absolutely an amazing thing. So, hear me out before you get mad about, oh no, they didn't add trading. I hate trading. So, let me tell you why. First of all, because they will never add trades, we will never get the stupid spam in the chat. Like, Bowie, can you please give me that fishing rod? Bowie, can you please give me that fish? Oh, can you please give me a shark egg? Hey, I'm new. Do somebody have some gold for me? It's so annoying and it ruins games for me. And last but not least, I totally agree with them that if a new player unlocks a new island, it feels really great to catch all the fish yourself. But if you already traded the fish before, what's even the point of a new island? I do understand that probably a lot of people are really sad about trading not being in the game, are probably really angry, and don't share the same opinion as I do. I really want to ask you to stay respectful in the Fishing Simulator Discord and in the comments. This is just the way how they want their game to be, and you know, we can't really do anything about it. I mean, duplication glitches with trading is something that existed for super long, and it's super logical that they don't want to ruin their economy right now. So guys, what are the new stuff that you are the most excited about? Personally for me, I would really want to see what they are up to with the neon sharks. I really hope it will be worth the grind. Another thing that I'm really excited for is the pets. Because in my head, it just feels amazing to have this parrot flying around, all the pirate life and stuff. Really cool. But anyway, guys, thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video and want to see more, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.